Makhosi, makhosi, makhosi. Ngiyanamukela nina lapha emakhaya, you beautiful Kermites, to another episode and another installment, exciting installment of Kermi TV. Yilo leli gedla le, igedla lamashikushikuri inyama yamakhosi. And I welcome you guys. Guys, I want to apologize for not consistently dropping content. It becomes hard with a whole lot of other things that I have to do on the side. Kodwa ngihlale ngiyinkumbula. Angiyinkhohlwa, ngiyanithanda ngothando lukampela inqane. Yingakho ngibuyile. Angifuni ginqa amagula bakwethu. Today we're covering another part or another session of the series that we started, which we called Back to the Basics. Kodwa namhlanje, I just want to cover spirits that a lot of people talk about, but there's misconceptions, and I want to give my understanding of it, and I want to give Kermi TV's perspective of these spirits. Lana, if you've seen the thumbnail, you'll see that namhlanje just khuluma about the three primary spirits that abantu abaningi try to explain, but they don't explain correctly, or they explain and leave things out. I might leave things out on this episode. You can go into the comment section, but I am going to give my understanding, and I am going to give my knowledge based on my research and my experiences with the ones that I have, and my knowledge from those that I received that also possess the ones that I don't have. Bakwethu, namhlanje sikhuluma ngeNzuza, sikhuluma ngeNkosazana, bese sikhuluma ngNkosi yami, Inkanyamba. Yeah. Yilo leli gedla lamashikashikashi, inyanga yamakhosi. Guys, I'm gonna try and keep this episode short because I'm tired. We won't study salapa for hours watching Kermi TV. I like to give you compacted information, and upon your request, nisho ukuthi jula mkhulu, jula ungene ngaphakathi enjulweni. But today I will try and explain these spirits as clearly as possible to you guys. Ukuthi siqale, I would like us to tap into a spirit I am familiar with, which is Inzuza. Bakwethu, there are a lot of explanations online regarding Inzuza. Misunderstandings and incomplete explanations regarding Inzuza. Ukuthi Inzuza yini? Inzuza ingena abantu abanjani? Uba ibangena, isiveza kanjani uba ibangenile? Now, I've come across during my research, aside from my experience, that there is a misconception or misunderstanding and sometimes a confusion between Inzuza no Mdao, or a specific type of Mdao, because there are different types of Mdao. So, ngizoqala ngokuexplaina ukuthi uma bakhuluma ngamaNzuza, basuke bakhuluma ngokuthi ungenwe idlozi elinjani. They would be talking, or rather you would be confusing ucabanga ukuthi ungenwe inzuza, kodwa within idlozi lakho, within your lineage, you have foreign blood, whether be it amaSulumane awasuka ngale waza ngapha, foreigners that came and they copulated or they mixed with the clan that you're from, and your bloodline has a part of that clan. And so you have somebody maybe who will dream of Amandiya, somebody who will dream of Amajuda, or somebody who will dream of Irish people, or somebody who will dream of English people. And then that spirit might figure, lelo dlozi malifika, because spirits, once they get that side, no longer sometimes use their identity, they'll use animals to represent themselves. And because baze ngolwandle, bazibonisa baza ngolwandle, uphuphe amanzi kakhulu, uphuphe amandiya kakhulu, uphuphe amajuda, or uphuphe whatever. And then you go to someone and makabheka, instead of ukuthi athi cha unomndawo or unamanzuza, cha akutshele ukuthi wena unenzuza, you are possessed by a water deity, which is not the case. Some people call people that possess this type of bloodline amanzuza. I recognize them as a certain type of umndawo. Kodwa lana sikhuluma ngenzuza. What is inzuza? Now, ekudalweni komhlaba, humans and animals were not the only creatures that were created. there was a vast majority of spiritual creatures that were created to inhabit the seas, inhabit all the heavens, inhabit the skies. Some of them are ethereal, some of them are fourth dimensional in their existence, meaning they possess light bodies. But they are not completely spiritual, so they are still able to manifest within the third dimension, but they can only be seen by those who possess the eye. Singajuli kakhulu when I say the eye. But Inzuza lesikhuluma ngayo izidalwa noma isidalwa thizeni esasemanzini, which is ethereal in form. We could go as far as saying that this thing, lenyoka, it appears as a snake, but it is a deity. I hope you understand. Inzuza is a deity. If we are to explain it in English, to not mistranslate it, angeke sisebenzise igama lesintu because kuzoba ukuthi sibiza isithixo manje, which Inzuza I konzeki, you can't worship Inzuza. Inzuza is an ancient spirit that was created along with other spirits. It was never a living spirit, akusiyinhlosi. It is a spiritual creature, a very high level spiritual creature. How does it go about ukuthi umuntu angenwe yinzuza? Now, of old, because now we are more tainted these days, the food we eat, the water we drink, the experiences that we have, the entertainment has caused our light eye, our one eye, to be closed. We are no longer as spiritually sensitive or as spiritually perceptive as our ancestors were. And because we are not as pure as they were, these creatures have shied away, these deities have shied away from us. Hence, not a lot of people can see these things like they used to back in the day. Kodwa, back in the day, abantu bebakhona ukuzibona lezinto because they were more pure, because intentions were more pure, because humans were not as destructive and corrupt as they are today. People were able to interact nalezi, and thus you had people that were spiritual that would form covenants for certain power, for certain reasons. Depending on your lineage, I can't tell your story. I can only tell my story. Of which angeke ngijule ngoba inzuza into enemfihlo. So, it would be ukuthi umuntu onomoya wenzuza is because they had a spiritual person in their lineage who had a covenant, an agreement, who had an interaction with Inzuza, and through that, him or her, naleyo Inzuza, had a pact for whatever reason. Hence why Inzuza might figure with different reasons. Not everybody uzothola Inzuza for the same reason, and hence why not everybody is going to see Inzuza or na Inzuza. It would depend on the depth of the agreement, the interaction that your ancestor had. But it would be through a water covenant. Now, when I say water covenant, I'm columnist to her. It would be an agreement, or it would have been a contract that you, your ancestor, and Inzuza now have. Ukuthi your generation, your lineage, is going to be my servants, or rather my children, and they are going to serve me. In turn, I will give them this type of power. Makhosi, I do hope ukuthi I'm clarifying ukuthi nina enenzuza niyithole kanjani inzuza. Inzuza can appear in many different forms. Now, there is a question mark that is hovering above these deities, which is it just one or is it just many? Mina ngokwami, I cannot claim ukuthi inzuza yami ngiyedwa, because it's never communicated that way. Mele siyeke lento yokuthi sikhulume into engakaqondiswa uloyo moya, because that's what creates misconception. For all you know, there were multitudes of these water type deities that were created. And so now the umbrella term for them is Inzuza. But what I can tell you is these are etheric, spiritual, reptilian like creatures, snakes. If ni being akuma zivela, zivela ziyindlo, inyoka ezinkulu ezasemanzini. generally people abazongenwa inzuza abantu either that are connected to Nkosi somehow, or it would be people that, how can I put it? Or rather, let me put it this way. Once there was a covenant between your ancestor and Inzuza, you become Ubanamakuwanukosi Masimansi. I've picked up through my research that majority of people, Aban Inzuza, somehow have a makosi of some sort in their bloodline. So it remains to be confirmed whether abantu abanamakhosi abathola inzuza only, or people that had this covenant are now regarded as people that are by proxy connected to ubukhosi basemazi. But munenzuza generally it will appear nobukhosi of some sort. Makhosi, now what effects does inzuza have on people that experience it? Asike sicacise kuqala nje ukuthi inzuza works different things. It's not only wealth, it's not only ukulapha, it's not only gifts of prayer. This spirit has, it could come with multiple reasons to you, all of them, or it could come with one. With my fike empilweni yakho wena, it's brought you ukuthandeka, faith, or wena it's brought you wealth, or wena it's brought you spiritual power, which we love amanzi. Moya manzi, ukhuleka, uthinta amanzi, umuntu uyaphola. It could come with many of those things. Primarily, what does it affect? Inzuza affects relationships, bafethu. It tends to want to choose partners for you. Yingakho, it's kind of like amakhosi. Just like amakhosi like to choose who you can be with and kick out people they don't like, inzuza is exactly alike, and they do it even with your friends. They do. Because umoya uhlanzekile, umoya ugezekile, it does not just want anybody to be around you. Because you must always be not tainted, or rather be cleansed mentally, emotionally, and spiritually. And if you are not, it has the habit of forcing you to go through purification or blocking izinto zakho. Ifale yonke into igulise ngempela. In fact, iziyabula inzuza. Ayidlali. For those of you in Inzuza, you can relate to what I'm talking about, but it affects your relationships. It's very specific about who you date and who you are with. Inzuza also blesses certain things in your life. And if ingavumi into thizeni leyo nto leyo ukuthi uyayithinta, because people with Inzuza tend to have what we call the Midas touch or the golden touch. Into abayithintayo iyaphakama. Kodwa mele ibe ihambelana nefiso zayo leyo nzuza. So if ivume ukuthi hayi wena ufuna ukuthi uphakame ngamabhizinisi, ufuna ukuthi usebenze, you can work years and years and years for a company, uloku ubona abantu bangena bakudlula, ungazi ukuthi why am I not being recognized, uze uthola ama-warning, ufake ku-performance management, uqoshwe inzuza. Uthi mo soqoshe uthathe i-package lakho uthi uvula ibhizinisi esimple nje, uthengise amaqanda, leyo business ithi inzuza, because ikunike amandla kwebhizinisi. Sometimes ungadingi nokuthwala uthi nje ukhipha amaculo i-1, 2, 3, inzuza iqhumise, it's given you fame. Isebenza nje kanjalo bakwethu. Inzuza ayithandi umnikelo. Inzuza ithanda ukuthi ube semanzini kakhulu, uhlale ukhuleka khona emanzini all the time. Uqhumana nayo kanjalo, because it is a pure spirit. Akumelanga nokugijima emanzini uhlabana nenkukhu, ujijela usika imbuzi lapho uchitha igazi emanzini, uqala nomoya lo, ngoba le nto oyidlisayo akusinzuza. Inzuza angeke iloku idla igazi. Ifuna ukuthi ube semanzini, fasting, going to the water and praying there. Inzuza is self-activated, by the way. To those of you that primarily, your primary spirit, eningeni le inzuza, usually izohamba no prophecy of some sort. Not all the time, but usually izohamba no prophecy of some sort. Now, with that said, it's self-initiatory. Lomoya okhoni ukuthi wena ujahe. Hamba udla amagobongo wakutshela ukuthi nali igobongo lenzuza. Inzuza ayinayo ukhamba. Nayo imithi yakhona, cha. generally speaking, yona it will take things at its own pace. Masifuna ukuthi wenze lokho after 8 months izokwenzisa lokho. Mayifuna ukuthi wenze lokho in the next 2 weeks after 8 months izokwenzisa lokho. You must just follow what it's asking in order ukuthi yona iqhubeka ikunika amandla wayo, iqhubeka ikulekelela. People abanenzuza kakhulu will find that their journey is so terribly hard and confusing because ujika la utshela ukuthi kumele uyobhala kwindawo, ujika la utshela ukuthi hayi wena kumele uphakamise isithunywa nje kuphela, ujika la. But the whole issue behind that is just that you have water spirits that are doing things at their own pace. So yekela ukulokugijima uhlola la uhlola la uhlola la uhlola. If you need to get a mentor on Inzuza, get a mentor on Inzuza to teach you more regarding the spirit and to guide you more regarding the spirit. I'm funeking amagula kakhulu and dwell on this too much. If I've missed anything, please go into the comment section and tell me Mkhulu, you've missed this, please cover it. But that's Inzuza in a nutshell. Generally people that have Inzuza are even if you're not good looking, you're attractive and you'll be likable to people. It's not that ukuthi you will have a lot of friends. When people see you from far, you will be likable. You will be attractive. Keep it like that. Ngicabanga manje ukuthi kumele ugijime ube nabangani abayi 2000. Izobahlanza bonke lenyoka le. Be careful. That's Inzuza in a nutshell, guys. Angifuni ukuthi this video must go to 30 minutes because we still have other spirits to cover. Now, because we are about to go into a spirit that is so confusing because there's a whole lot of indaba about this. Hey, mina ngabona inkosazana. Hey, mina ngithwalisa inkosazana. Hey, kunje. Ngihamba ngiyenza umnikelo kunkosazana. Ngizothola umnotho. Bakwethu, I'm gonna try and explain le nkosazana le ukuthi what it is. Now, in the sea, there are a lot of beings that are sentient like you and me. But because of history, they keep their distance from us because we are the type of creatures as humans. Ukuthi masibona into esingayazi, sibona ispider singayo. Ukuthi si poisonous noma sikho poisonous, asicabanga ukuthi siyasinyathela. Yebo, kehla. Siyasinyathela. Ngeni kata singagqokisisi kahle sifake imvubu shayela into le ibaleke. We are those type of creatures. We are the type of creatures that don't think twice. You give us a thumb, we'll make a club and beat our own brother down. And hence, they see our barbaricness and they keep distance because most water spirits, most water beings are very clean. Most water beings are very pure. And the human population as it is, the human race as it is far fallen from grace. Now, what are the origins of Inkosazana? Bakwethu, ngizocaphuna nje in ancient theology, in ancient teachings, in ancient spirituality, spiritual books. When the Archons, by Archons I mean when the Watchers, the angels, came down here to the earth and they started genetically experimenting. The Bible says they started sleeping with women, but it was genetic experimentations. They were mixing different animals with different beings, different animals with humans, mixing their genes, animals and human genes, experimenting. Out of all these experiments, there were water creatures or water beings that were created. Primarily today, I want to cover ukuthi you must understand ukuthi we have what we call sirens. Sirens are violent fish people. Akusabantu lawa. They might have some sort of, they are called aquatic apes. Sirens are not to be played with. Khona inyanga maybe esigijimayo and they see a siren and they think they saw inkosazana bafike balimale. They have no medicinal properties. They are a very violent being because of how humans have been towards them, killing them century after century. There's been archaeological finds in caves, paintings thousands of years old of people that are half fish, half human, running back to the sea, running away from spears and bows and arrows. thina esihlasela bona. We are attacking sirens, not Inkosazana. And then you have mer people. So buya lapho. Then we have fish people. Some of you in your dreams will dream of abantu that they are anthropomorphic. In other words, labantu laba can stand on 2 feet, have 2 hands, and have the shape of a human body. But more bigger, this person is not a human. They have the traits of a fish. These are fish people. This is not Inkosazana. This is the Nemo, a race of the sea, a sentient race of the sea. They have a world in the sea. They are not Inkosazana. Some of you, some of your ancestors might have interactions with these people at whatever level. And hence uzophupha labantu usuke ungenolo moya, not Inkosazana. Now, when we talk about Inkosazana, we are talking about mer people, mermaids. Now, amongst many creatures that were created, there were creatures that had spiritual powers due to the fact that the Watchers or the Archons were not simply third-dimensional beings, but they were fourth-dimensional in the existence, meaning they belonged to a higher realm. And hence it was an abomination for a higher consciousness to lower its vibration and come into creatures that are of a lower consciousness and alter them. And in their alteration, you had creatures like the Nephilim that were born. The Nephilim, which were the violent giants. You had creatures like the Centaurs, half horse, half man. You had creatures like the creature called Pan, half goat, half man. Hence, in mythology, you see zonke ilwanelezi uzibuze ukuthi besiphumaphi. It was the Archons' creation, trying to be like God, but they were not God. Mer people were the result, they were the children, the sons and daughters of the Archons. Mer people were super, or rather, let me not use super powerful. Mer people had spiritual powers, along with the fact that they were half human and part fish. They were the result of the DNA of sea creatures being mixed with angel DNA being mixed with human DNA. Yiyo Inkosazana leyo, a spiritual water ancestor of ours. But unlike us, they had more angel DNA than we do. Hence why ukuthi uzwe ukuthi uma uhlangana nenkosazana unika umnikelo ikhona ukukunika into ethizeni, ikhona ukukuvulela inhlanhla, konke. It's because it is not only ukuthi it's a mer person. No, this creature as well has still a lot of its angelic DNA active. Hence you find ukuthi abanye bayakhona ukuyibona, abanye bakhona ukuyibona. It can move between its ethereal body ukuthi ingabonakali, and then reappear in its physical body. But always, due to the fact that it's got these parts of DNA, it'll appear as half fish, half human. Mara moy bega, you will see ukuthi cha lo muntu lo akusumuntu, is not a normal human from the appearance. You'll see ukuthi although they are sentient, although they might be able to speak, they are definitely very far removed in terms of being human. Now, we've covered sirens, mer people, fish people. Now we also have water deities. Along with Inzuza, there are some water deities who appear in the form that might look like mer people. But angifune ukujula kakhulu lapho, because now we're talking about creatures like mummy water. Not creatures, we're talking about deities like mummy water. We're talking about isn't this true. Last ikhuluma ngokuthi umuntu ongenwe inkosazana, usually your family has some connection to mer people, mermaids, mermen. Hence Inkosazana, a mermaid, part human, part fish, part angel. And hence why generally uzothola ukuthi, just like Inzuza, you had an ancient ancestor who was pure enough, or pure enough for that specific type of creature to approach and have a conversation, an agreement, an interaction, a relationship with them. As to what type of relationship, angifune ukujula ngithi there was There was a covenant, there was a story, there was whatever, but there was an interaction, there was a covenant, there was some sort of agreement between you and that bloodline. Naleyo Nkosazana yathanda abantu begazi lakho, and so it's able now to contact abantu abaxhumane naleyo gazi somehow. Yingakho uzothiwa uphuphe ubizwa inkosazana. It's because your ancestor had some sort of interaction with that specific being. Now, people usually have an inkosazana because it's because of its nature. You'll find ukuthi kakhulukazi amantombazana angenwa inkosazana. They like being flashy, they like makeup, they like colorful hair, they like bright clothes. It's people abathanda ukugqama. Because now you might bonakala inkosazana iyagqama. You cannot miss ukuthi nayo. It's beautiful. Although it might not look human, it's beautiful muyibona. It's a magical creature, if I can put it like that. Hence why umuntu ongenwe inkosazana, they will want to appear magical, mobapeka, adorn themselves with beads, nezinto eziningi. Generally, uma indoda ingenwe inkosazana nabo, you will find that they have very feminine features. If not physically, when you approach them, or when you speak to them, you'll feel a very strong presence of an attractive female. But my gauge, if we know that I'll tell you not enjalo, when I'm talking about pazamile, hey, my boys. So you will usually have that. In order to inkosazana, just like I mentioned, with Inzuza, it's self-initiatory. Inkosazana generally, you have what we call marine cults. Unfortunately, I'll use the word cults, but I'll say marine groups that have a group of people that all possess Inkosazana, and they know the initiatory rites and how to connect you with that spirit. I can't speak too deeply about that because angifune ukunyathela amakhonsi. That part is very dangerous. I could get in serious trouble. But those people usually are people initiated into the marine kingdom. If you suspect or you've confirmed ukuthi unenkosazana, hambe lwandle uyophahla, fike laphaya uphahle ngenqwaba yamakhoyina silver. We visit Inkosazana and ask to get a guide, ask for somebody from the marine kingdom to come and help you. Kakhulukazi if Inkosazana, you'll find that a lot of people like spending money. That becomes the situation. People like spending money on you. They are attracted and abasaba ukuchithela imali ngaphezu kwakho. That's Inkosazana in a nutshell. Generally, it will either come with fame or umcebo. Ayisebenze into, ayilaphi inkosazana. Bakwethu, just a note, angifune ukukhulumela enye into emayelana ukuthwaliswa ngenkosazana or uye lwandle uyenziswa ama-ritual omuntu who's not part of the marine kingdom for inkosazana. Please be careful of those things. A lot of people have gotten hurt because or baphuma lapha baphuma bacabanga ukuthi bathwaliseke inkosazana kanti uyolalwa nje omunye umoya njalo nje uzokuqalaza. So just be careful regarding that. Inkosazana is a pure spirit. It's not a spirit ezoletha usizwe empilweni yakho, ezoloke ifuna ukugqilaza ilala nawe yenza izinto ezisnacks. So regarding that, I just wanted to clarify that because there's a few things that I've seen online. And yeah, bakwethu, without ginqamagula, asike simuve to our final spirit, Nkosi yami, Inkanyamba. Let me take a sip. Inkanyamba, bakwethu. What is Inkanyamba? Abantu babhayizela umoya bangawu-understand. In the Bible, when the earth was originally formed, or rather, when the worlds were originally formed, Tinati the earth. In fact, when I say when the worlds were formed, they were all formed out of what we call the primordial waters, first waters. Out of the first waters, there was a creature created, and by Belinda, they mentioned that creature, the water dragon, Leviathan. That is Inkanyamba. the snake ukuthi when it comes from the depths, uma nje ikhipha ikhanda elwandle, the skies begin to rumble, causes tornadoes, kusumoya omncane, and hayi noma ubani ongenwa yinkanyamba, hayi noma ubani ogijimayo aloku athi mina nginenkanyamba, mina nginenkanyamba, okhoni ukuthwalisa umuntu nenkanyamba. I stand by that word because it is much older in terms of the spirits I've mentioned. It is a much more older and a much more powerful and a much more dangerous spirit. Ukuthi abantu bakhethwa kanjani inkanyamba, it remains a mystery to me. Kodwa, in order to possess inkanyamba, it chooses you. I don't know how the ancestors used to contact the Leviathan. Angifune ukukhuluma into noma ngiyisanuzi, cha angifune ukukhuluma into which I have not received the download about for now. Kodwa know ukuthi uma unenkanyamba, it must choose you. Awukhoni ukuhamba uyo-invoke inkanyamba. And if you are zama by being given some right, you will cause storms that are gonna cause landslides, that are gonna cause tornadoes, that are gonna destroy many houses. Ulwandle will go into chaos. Because that is not a small spirit, that is not a small deity, it's something serious. In fact, God himself in the scripture says, ukuthi, can you tame the Leviathan? Kosiya, buzu mbuzu, ochuli, nkulunkulu mazo buza wana uti. Who amongst you, mankind, can tame the great dragon in the sea? None of you. Powerful spirit. When invoked by people that are not its children, or rather when people try to call upon it, it's known ukuthi it causes storms. It's a very violent deity. It stays in the depths of the depths of the waters. So ithanda ukuthula. So its children generally bafuneka ukuthi babe sethuleni. Angebe ube umuntu ohamba umsindo ohlale unabantu abaningi around you unenkanyamba. Ngoba uma ungenwe inkanyamba, just as when it's done wrong, it invokes tornadoes and it causes the water to go back and forth. Likewise, now uba nenhliziyo encane. In fact, umuntu onenkanyamba has a short temper. So short, akuthatha okuningi ukuthi umkwatise, uma umbhedela, impala iqhuma manje. Uma angakuzisisi kahle, ukushaya manje. It's not them, it's because this male spirit, because it is predominantly a male spirit. In fact, not predominantly, it is a male spirit. It is a male deity. So it comes with male characteristics. Uma ingena kwintombazane, it's very, very hard. Ukujola nentombazane nenkanyamba, Nkosi yami. Ngoba yilaba abakutshelayo ukuthi angibhedelwa mina nyabonyana. Angibhedelwa nje ngiyabonyana, ungalingi nje uxobe kuyanudaka. The people that actually receive the spirit generally are healers, generally are prophets. From what I've seen, I stand as well to be corrected, people can add more to that, but from what I've seen, abantwana benkanyamba will receive usually some sort of prophetic power. Because this deity dwells in silence, you must teach yourself in order to connect with it to always be in places that don't have too much noise, like ngaliwa kona, like ngananqabana kona. In order for it to uthihlaliseke, you mustn't be umuntu ohlali alwa akhuluma aya phansi phezulu, because it is generally nalayihleli khona manje, it's in silence. Inkanyamba bakwethu, you cannot. When you're doing an offering as umntana wenkanyamba, you cannot offer it blood. Ayidli gazi. Yebo, it will take the offering in a way that I'm not allowed to disclose right now. Kodwa uma uzoya uthi you dedicate igazi, uyohlaba imbuzi, uyohlaba inkomo, inkukhu le lwandle ngoba ufuna ukudlisa inkanyamba, uyamosha, uyangcolisa and uzoyithola lento oyifunayo. It asks for constant fasting because ifuna ukuthi uhlale uhlambulukile ukuthi amandla wayo ukuthi nayo ikhona ukufika kuwo. Abantwana abaningi benkanyamba abakhoni ukulungisa lo moya because they do not fast enough they are not clean enough. Umuntu onenkanyamba, because it's such a powerful spirit, needs to constantly fast. Constantly fast. Constantly fast. Constantly purifying themselves. When lo moyo usulungisiwe, because it's so powerful, it usually grants rulership. Rulership of whatever kind. Ukuthi uzoba nenkonzo enkulu, ukuthi you're gonna be a king, whatever. It comes with rulership and it comes with wealth. Naturally, it comes with wealth and it grants you power over people. So, that's Inkanyamba bakwethu. If I've missed anything during this segment, please go into the comment section and tell me Mkhulu Sseida. That's not the case. Please go ahead and cover this again, or you forgot to add this. Go into the comment section. I appreciate the comments. Continue liking, sharing, and subscribing. I wanted to keep this short. I love you guys. Please continue subscribing. I love all you care minds. Mkhulu Sseida no. Iketla lama shkushkur. Inyama yama kosi. Nginibonga nongi niti. Mtano mtano lambe. Makosi.